understand, Al. I'm sorry if I made you feel less than who you are. A little insecure. Oh, you're the shining star. I wanna spend my nights with you, my life with you. Oh, baby, baby, please wait up for me till whenever I get home. I know that you're on the
Hey bitches, what's really going on, honey? That's right, I'm back. Yes, bitch TV is here. We queer, we everywhere, honey. Okay. Excuse the smacking. I got here with me today carrots, celery, chimichurri, hummus, bitch. Okay. 2 weeks, full 2 weeks, no meat, straight vegetarian status. All right. I've been doing really good, and I have not been craving a motherfucking steak, no fried chicken, none of that shit. I could watch the cooking channel off the Chopped all day long and not crave meat no more. I'm so proud of my motherfucking self, but I will say the toilet paper bill has gone the fuck up. The baby wipes bill has gone the fuck up, bitch. When you start tearing into the healthy shit, they don't tell you that your body is about to expel all of that shit, honey. Let me tell you, expecto patronus, honey. I need something to guide the light, bitch, okay? Ooh, girl, get me the patronus, Tom. Where is Harry Potter when you need him, honey, okay? Anyway, I just came to talk some shit. So the first thing I'm here to discuss, I was scrolling through my Instagram this morning, and I came across a clip. I guess the new season of the Kardashians is about to drop, or it has already dropped, but I saw the clip that seemed like it was just promoting that episode. And it's a clip of Kourtney on the phone. You got Kris Jenner, Khloe, and Kim at home, and you got Kourtney on the phone crying, cussing all them bitches out, talking about some, y'all are mean, for saying that I don't do shit and I don't bring nothing to the table business-wise. I enjoy being a mother to my three kids, and why is that such a problem? And blah, 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 blah. Basically, made me think to myself when I heard that. And I had to pause because I wanted to see what the sister's response or the mom's response was going to be. Child, Khloe, Kris was trying to play nice. Kim Kardashian was not with the motherfucking bullshit. Kim Kardashian West was not with the motherfucking bullshit. And there's a difference between those two types of bitches. See, Kim Kardashian was pre-West era, bitch, okay? Motherfucking West is the now bitch. Because there's a difference when a bitch hooks up with the black culture, there's a shift in her motherfucking attitude and her behaviors. Her perception on life is much motherfucking different and healthier, bitch, okay? You can see clearly now the rain is gone, bitch. When you come over to the dark side, bitch, you know what they say, once you go black, you never go back, okay? Yes, you better know it, bitch. You better motherfucking know the shit, okay? Hold on 1 second. Now, Kim basically said, bitch, you don't do shit. You don't do a motherfucking thing. You just sit on your back, basically, and pop out these motherfucking children. I'm giving my own example on that. Kim did not say that to her sister, but basically, she might as well. She told the hoe, you don't do fucking shit. You're lazy as fuck. And you know what? It made me ask the question. What do you bring to the table business-wise, bitch? Besides interior decorating that I see on the show, but last time I checked, you don't do that professionally. And I do know you have a degree. So it bothers me to know that. What are you good for, bitch? What are you good for instead of stealing cameras and photographers? Now, let's be honest, your Kourtney was never the one that we all looked to. Kim was obviously the reason for the season for these fucking bitches. If it wasn't for Kim K and the wits and power of Kris Jenner, bitch, let's be honest here, they would still, all of them would be working at IHOP right now. Let's be, huh? Robert Kardashian passed on before the real money was made. Let's be real here. Kim Kardashian started off motherfucking wardrobe organizing for Paris Hilton when it was called wardrobe organizing. Now everyone just calls herself stylist, knowing damn well they're working in the back of a bitch's closet. You might as well work at the Gap. Shit. But it's the truth, though. They started literally from like almost nothing. Yes, they have a better privilege because of their statue at the time. But let's be real here. Robert Kardashian wasn't going to take that in an infamous way. That OJ shit blew over and get gone. And then right shortly, what, not too long after that, Robert Kardashian passed on to the next life. May he rest in peace. So I'm quite sure, yes, he did have a starting foundation for them. But at the end of the day, when you think about this money now, bitch, they hustled for that shit. I'm not trying to give them props or grand, but you have to really take a step back and look. I'm not mad at it. Y'all, they leverage situations to gain the upper hand on these bitches. Now they're the most powerful family in the world. In the world. And has maintained this status in 10 plus years. We've seen their children's children grow the fuck up. Let's be honest here. We've seen Kylie and Kendall pre-ugly, you know, post-beautiful. We saw Bruce Jenner when he was around here looking like the box of Wheaties that his picture was on back in the 90s and in the 90s when he was running through the Olympics and shit. Now she's over here looking like, child, we don't know what that hoe's looking like, but but anyway, I'm just trying to sit here. Through it all, Kourtney, you have not brought nothing to the table. But laying on your back for the same, you got three kids by the same ain't shit nigga. And making kids to me is not a special thing. Anybody can pop out a fucking kid. What are you bringing to the table, bitch? That's the motherfucking question. And once, and Kim Kardashian, her response was everything. And that's how you know. This ain't the same Kim K we used to see back then. Once you go black, you don't go back. Her, everything about her's changed now, and I'm here for it. I'm here for every fucking bit of the shit. She's telling the truth, bitch. What are you doing? Kim Kardashian, shit. They got the stores. They got the perfume. Kim Kardashian don't give a fuck about this shit no more. She don't. You know what she's caring about now? She's caring about justice, social justice. Now that she's had a taste of what it is, a consistent taste of the black culture, the livelihood of black men and women and how we are treated in America, how we are even ostracized in our own communities because of these wars that white people want to pin against us. We're already living in underwhelming, shitty conditions. We're already living extreme lives just by to walk out of our motherfucking front door sometimes. Our neighbors, we should be loving each other. You know, I'm just getting to a whole new section, but y'all know what the fuck I'm talking about, okay? Kim Kardashian now has black children. Her husband is from Chicago. Her husband has faced a lot of different fucking adversities in his life, especially losing his mother. You know what I'm saying? He's going through a lot right now, battling depression and bipolar disorders and shit like that. She now understands, and you see her focus has switched. You don't really see Kim K on the bullshit no more. You see her fighting for social justice. You see her out here to the White House. Don't give a fuck which president is doing her best to get bitches free out of jail for shit they didn't don't know to be in there that long for. Black women, people's mother, grandmother, daughter, aunt. That's somebody. You know what I'm saying? Like, what the fuck is wrong with you people for trying to come at this girl, for trying to set a bitch free? If that was your homeboy or your homegirl, your grandma, your auntie, your cousin, you know you want that motherfucker to be set free. Someone that you love and care about. I don't give a fuck who at whose hand it was by. Thank you, bitch. That's all a bitch needs. So now Kim K's, her focus switched. Bitch, what do you do? What have you been doing? What's going on now? What the fuck you got going on, bitch? Nothing, Kourtney. You can't fight it. You can't deny it. But don't worry. We'll walk right on by it. Okay? Huh, bitch. Moving on. T.I. really quickly. You know, I was at work sometimes. You know, I have to catch up on the shows, child. And I used to love watching Hit the Floor. So, bitch, I was like, ooh, season 4 is out. I don't feel right starting the new season, and I'm not caught up on all the shit. So I had to start it all over. But I noticed on demand, every fucking commercial was promoting T.I.'s show. I guess Hustle or whatever the fuck it's called. And I started to think to myself. So basically, I guess the premise of the show is him finding someone to help him run a business or giving someone an opportunity within his company or whatever the fucking case may be. And I thought about it. I said, T.I., you know, musically, I don't really care for you that much anymore like I used to when you first came out. But I guess the same could be said for every other artist. You're always hot when your first album or your first mixtape. But then as the years go by and you done made your money, you don't give a fuck about the quality of the music anymore. You trying to venture off in other business situations. And I'm fine with that shit. That's cool. That's elevation. That's progress. That's what the fuck you're supposed to do. So, but T.I., I don't really, and you talk a good game, and I know you done probably read the encyclopedias every time you got locked up because you wanted to sound smart in front of lawyers and white people and bring shock and awe. And hey, I commend a black man from the hood that can speak words other than fuck you, bitch, and all this other shit. I can appreciate that. I'm not going to take that away from you. You definitely have solid arguments, but let's be real here. There has been no organization in your personal life, how you deal with your wife, how you deal with your side pieces that need to be remain silent. Because as Sean Bradley would say, honey, yes, God, hoes want to be counted. And they sure do. And they done divided and conquered the empire that Tiny helped you build. So you fucked up that situation. Then on top of that, you have a great relationship with your kids, so we see visually on TV, but we really don't know how you deal with them. Because honest to God, a bitch who was stocking up guns, I didn't trust, first of all, let's jump on him real quick in his past. I don't trust no motherfucker who is a felon, has violated multiple times on his probation, and still can find a way to do less time than any normal human being that would have got caught with the amount of guns and drugs that man had on him. Every time. If he was a normal man, he would have been under 100 years. We would have forgot about the bitch. Okay? That's just real tea. I didn't trust the situation once I... And that happens to like Quavo just had to happen to him. Bitch, you're supposed to be up the road. Whose titties you signing to get free? I would just love to know. But anyway, that's neither here nor there. But T.I. cannot organize his own restaurant that had, I think, was reportedly closed down because he had all these fees and stuff that he owed. I don't know if that was a shady business deal. I don't know what the fuck it was, but reports were bitches weren't getting paid. And bitches stopped coming to work until the check cleared. So whose responsibility is on that? Who he held up? I know he don't know nothing about no restaurants, so he probably had a friend and he became an investor in the situation, and I can definitely understand that. But don't be trying to organize these situations and you ain't got your own house in order. I don't want to work for nobody who can't keep the reins on their own motherfucking life. Okay, and that's for T. I know you got to do your thing, and VH1 and BET is just around here giving out shows to people left and right just so they can say they're helping out the black communities, which a lot of these shows are unrelatable that y'all putting out there, all these reality, everything is, nothing is relatable to the people anymore. The masses are crying out for, why you think the ratings are so low on all of these shows? But let's keep it real, T.I., I don't want to take no life advice from a nigga like you. Until you show me the receipts that all those people have been paid their due, fuck you, okay? Now, let's talk about this other subject. A couple of days ago, there was a short video released of two baseball players that play for the Atlanta Braves, and Acuna Jr. and Ozzie something. Apparently, these two men were, you know, hugged up, not in a sensual way, not in an intimate way, more so on Acuna Jr. Well, basically, it was reported that during the game, his mother passed away. So the tea is Acuna Jr. had been taking care of his mother for quite some time. She had been ill for quite some motherfucking time. And it's been reported that his mother passed away during the game. And that's why he was being consoled by his best friend. So apparently they grew up together. They got signed to the same baseball team or whatever the case may be. And they around here making all kinds of, because we all know baseball players make a lot more than a lot of these other motherfuckers out here. Also, depending on how hot they are, apparently these two guys are the ones to look to in the game. I don't give a fuck about sports. I think sports is nothing but a distraction. It is a smokescreen in life that is has Americans and only Americans consumed with this repetitive competition shit. And it's all for money, and it's lucrative, and crackers are behind all of it. But that's neither here nor there as well. Just another thing for bitches out here that are trying to wake up can think about, okay? But basically, people, they're getting backlash because motherfuckers, spectators, bitches on the sidelines, again, they want to be counted. And they're calling them gay. Homophobic slurs. Slandering these guys through the media left and motherfucking right. And, you know, I had to think about it, and I'm just like, whether the reports are true about his mother passing away or not, because there are conflicting reports, but the final report that I read said it did happen, but until we know for sure, I'm just going to say allegedly passed away. It's really sad that this day and age that as the viewing public, we can see two men. Yes, I will agree. At first glance, and the commentators had some like fucked up funny jokes to say while they were capturing this moment. And the guy was rubbing and caressing the boy's head, but not in an intimate way, but just like something to do to calm this boy down. Like, you know what I'm saying? How can I calm my friend down? He's hurting right now. What can I do to make him feel better in this moment? And let's be real here. Thank God he has a motherfucking friend. Thank God he has someone to cry to, bitch. Thank God in that moment when he needed someone the most, someone was there to console him. And this is exactly why all you motherfuckers out there laughing and crying and having something to say about the shit in a negative way. Guess what? Fuck you, you lonely bitch. That's why you ain't got no motherfucking friends. And that and this toxic masculine behavior and this thing that you guys of this machismo ass attitude, motherfuckers, you sit on this throne like if you look down upon men who don't exhibit the same fucking high testosterone attitudes as you do. That's why you don't have any real motherfucking friends. That's why you're around superficial motherfuckers who just daydream about bullshit all day and not real life shit. Okay? Thank God this man had his friend there. Because ain't no telling what he may have done in that moment. Now, again, whether the reports are true about the mother, what the fuck does it matter if they were intimate with each other? Bitch, they play for the Atlanta Braves. I'm sure the check is clearing every time it comes through. Amen? Can I get an amen for the check clearing, bitch? The check has cleared. Okay? And they ain't no measly local banks. They got private business banks, bitch. Okay? So they're in a whole nother tax bracket than us poor motherfuckers. So why do we want to bring these men down? Shit, let's keep it real. The MLB's the only one recruiting motherfucking people from other countries. You see the football league doing that? Do you see basketball doing that anymore? Hell nah, bitch. If you ain't Yao Ming, you ain't doing shit. The MLB is the only one that's recruiting motherfuckers that's out of our country, giving motherfuckers an opportunity to come over here and slay it, bitch, so they can give back to their own people. That's what the fuck it's about. Coming to collect and exploit the motherfucking talent to get these gains, bitch, so I can serve my motherfucking people. So we can live better lives, okay? I don't see nothing wrong with it. And y'all want to sit back and judge these men for having a public display of affection. That's what the fuck is wrong with this sorry ass world and our judgmental ass attitudes, these fucked up perceptions on what we think should be a man. Now, it was said that someone, you know, showed support and was very outraged by a lot of the hate these men were receiving. Like, what the fuck? That's why niggas so scared to come out the closet now. Because you got sorry-ass motherfucking spectating-ass bitches sitting on the sidelines trying to judge other people's lives and situations. And come for them. If you're not here for the bullshit, you can leave the room, bitch. Whatever happened to one of these? Or one of these? Bitch, I'm gone because I don't want to hear the fuck shit. So I don't understand why everyone's such an uproar. Maybe I'm biased to the shit because I'm gay as fuck and I secretly would love it if that was the case. But bitch, whatever. Y'all need to stop allowing people to motherfucking judge you. You need to stop allowing these motherfuckers to sit around here and make you feel less than. You need to collect your motherfucking money. Because what's going to end up happening is some people, some dumb, small-minded motherfuckers are going to be sitting back in life. And you don't know, could come for their job. Oh, well, we don't want that kind of exposure on the MLB. We don't want that exposure. So let's go ahead and cut their con. What if they had sponsors that were like homophobic? Down low homophobia. You know, they can't publicly be that way because that's a lawsuit on their motherfucking ass. But let's be real here. What if they had a sponsor that was homophobic and they really are some, and they really are, or even if they aren't, it's even worse if they're not really gay. Let's be real here, bitch. They're losing their livelihoods because of hateful ass comments from raggedy ass bitches who sit on the sideline trying to judge other people's shit when your shit ain't together, bitch. Where is your car, bitch? Where is your money? Where is your family? Where is your business? Where is your motherfucking savings? Where is your motherfucking status at, bitch? What are you doing? All the people that's talking shit about these poor young men just trying to come out here and get this money and motherfucking, if they want to love each other, let them love each other. If that boy was consoling him because his mama passed away, that's what the fuck it was then. Why are y'all tripping? What is it to you? And you want to know why motherfucking niggas is hanging theyself and shooting theyself in the motherfucking head and overdosing on drugs, trying to hide their sexuality because raggedy bitches like y'all out here want to judge them. Fuck all of y'all. That's real tea, bitch. And I'm done for the day. I was trying to talk about some other things, but this video already longer than a motherfucker. So y'all have a wonderful day and thank y'all for tuning to Yes Bitch TV, honey. Yes, you better have a great day. You better show these raggedy motherfuckers out here in the world that try to come for your spirit, your soul, your motherfucking foundation. You better pray all of these motherfuckers away. Like they say, pray the gay away. Nah, pray the raggedy bitch away. Pray a touch a bitch and tell a bitch to leave you the fuck alone and let you do you, bitch, okay? You laugh at these hoes. You smile at these motherfuckers even when you don't feel like you have to or you have the strength to do so. Bitch, you better slap a bitch and tell that bitch to get a motherfucking life and stop worrying about what the fuck you got going on. Can I get an amen to the cause, bitch? Yes, God, honey. Y'all take care and be blessed. Yes, bitch.